This is the place where the emperor, the last emperor of the Tsarist Russia, is buried with his family, except for the two miners, including his daughter, Vodkin. They were found in the 1970s, in 82. They were uncovered, and then they covered again the remains by some people near Cathedral, and then after the collapse of the Soviet Union, they were brought out and given decent burial. So this is the place where Anastasia, Maria, Tatiana, the Tsar, and the Tsarina are buried, the remains. The Orthodox Church of Russia has canonized their persons or their remains. And this inner sanctum is right is the remains of some of the other. Oh, there's the chapel where I was just now. And here are the remains of some of the other royal families buried here for generations, ever since Peter the First or Peter the Great, who founded and built this city from scratch. And this is the Cathedral of St. Peter in St. Paul in Leningrad or St. Petersburg. And here, there's a little crocus of who's who and where is each one of the royal tombs. But basically, this cathedral is the one chosen for the burial of the whole royal family of Russia, Tsarist Russia, from Peter down to the last one, Nicholas II and his family, after their tragic deaths in the hands of some dirty killers in Ekaterinburg in 1917. Afraid of that they would be rescued by the White Russians and the Cossacks, who were very loyal to them, Lenin sent his thugs to kill them after being in prison for months and months and months in the Epatie house near Ekaterinburg. So now I am departing, and I'm gonna sit there quietly and meditate. Beautiful little church.